Hello, this is Eric. I've been working on the ESP32Berry project by myself. This is a very interesting project for me, and I think I'm answering the question of how far I can go based on microcontrollers. As you know, this is a TDEC device that runs on microcontrollers, specifically the ESP32S3. Since it is not an SBC like Raspberry Pi, it is based on FreeRTOS, not an operating system like Linux. This is an operating system, but it is very different from the OS we usually think of. It is only barely an OS or mainly helps you with concurrency. It supports many things, but at the same time, we must implement many things ourselves. Anyway, what I want to say is that if you want to study MCU-based embedded systems, there seems to be nothing better than this. Among them, the way I see it, it can be a great project for those who want to learn more about UI/UX that operates based on microcontrollers. In addition to receiving touch input from the screen, moving the cursor using trackball and input using a physical keyboard allows you to try out many things. That's really cool. What makes up the screen now is LVGL. I've done a lot of projects using LVGL. It's very nice, and I guess it's almost the only graphics library that can implement modern UI/UX on a microcontroller basis. So I love it, and I have no doubt more people will use it for their projects sooner or later. Today, I'd like to briefly share what I've been working on so far. I uploaded version 0.5 to my GitHub repository, which can operate the ESP32Berry project I worked on before based on TDEC. The program you see now works exactly the same in the same environment. This is the first screen after booting. This booting is very fast because it's an MCU. A pop-up dialog shows a welcome message and brief description of this project. You know what? I included a startup sound because the speaker is attached to this device. Let me restart this device. How is it? Isn't it cool? Listen again. I think it's really cool, just playing the MPC file from the SD card. More sound effects will be added. This is the home screen. I tried to make it similar to the old Blackberry home screen. Touching the top panels opens the control panel. Here you can adjust the volume, brightness, and Wi-Fi control. Currently, brightness can be adjusted in steps from 0 to 255. And the volume control is not yet implemented in the code. This is a simple version of the control panel. If we can make a better screen composition, we'll continue to upgrade it. Next is Wi-Fi. This is very important because most of the applications I'm going to build are based on some type of communication. Turn on Wi-Fi by tapping the Wi-Fi icon. Now starting searching for nearby Wi-Fi. If you press the Wi-Fi button, you can see the found Wi-Fi items. Pressing the Alt key and the B key on the keyboard together turns the keyboard right on and off. Let me enter the Wi-Fi password. Now trying to connect to the selected Wi-Fi. Alright, it's connected. As it's connected to the Wi-Fi, it updates the system time. It looks great even though it only displays the current date and time. Sorry, I just like it. This is the basic operating system environment. Nothing special, but basically everything we need is ready. Next, the application I prepared is the ChatGPT client. This worked on an earlier version of the ESP32Berry but was not published. So I'm excited to open it on the new ESP32Berry. In fact, this may not be very useful. We have a mobile application for ChatGPT through which you can try many more. However, I'm looking forward to doing a project using ChatGPT on a microcontroller as well. That's why I created the ChatGPT client library, and I'm also producing applications using it. It's simple, but it answers a lot of our questions. Also, since this is an application that needs to get text input from the user, I made this first because we have the physical keyboard and easy to get the text. What do you think? Google Bard is better or ChatGPT is better? I don't know who will be the strongest AI, but as long as you use everything well, it's enough. Everything I've been working on this project is being shared through my GitHub repository. I welcome all who wish to participate in this project. I couldn't even start working on the documentation yet. Really sorry about that. If we do this together, I think more people can participate. Today ends here. Thank you for watching. See you on the next version of this project.